come to your program developments and where we celebrate achievers and view the core potential of our day nation and also celebrate those that have contributed immensely to the building of the country. Today on the program, we'll be chatting with Engineer Fidel Okiria. He is the Managing Director, Nigerian Railway Corporation. Sit back, relax. I'll be right back.
First of all, we thank God we are seeing today and it's happening in our time. And Nigerians should say glory be to God because they are seeing the development and the stopping up. What I tell people, the train users always have peace of mind, unlike the road vehicle users. If you enter a car, everybody in the car is a driver because you feel the impact when they brake or the driver is on, unlike the train. You sit down, you can relax, you can walk, you can do anything. Now construction is taking place. The major beneficiaries are Nigerians because there are people being employed. Those the routes of the construction, people are being empowered either directly or indirectly. If you go to sites, you see people cooking food, selling water, selling minerals, kiosks springing up here and there. Like where they have finished, people are now establishing business. They're trying to have big land spaces for factories because for meaningful business, you have to be close for easy movements. And rail is the easiest way of moving something from anywhere. It can move in bulk, it's cheaper, and it's also safer. So Nigerians will benefit enormously, and they are benefiting as of now. For instance, the clamor for trade in Abuja has reached the peak, and the whole issue, and they are now using the trade service. And once you use it once, you always come back. So it's what we are facing now is the demand higher than supply, and government is also taking it seriously to ensure that we overcome that in the very short time. We have ordered more rolling stock, 64 of them, that will be deployed. They are earmarked for Lagos, Oritakwe, and Kaduna, Abuja. And as we develop our train service, and hopefully every year, I think with what has been proposed, that every year we should be able to be adding some rolling stock to our fleet. Because the mistake in the past was that maybe you buy 10, in the next 20, 15 years, don't buy anything. And those ones will be run down, and there will not be time for even to maintain them because the call for the service is there. Hopefully, I think now that we have a steady plan, we are sure that we never go back to the past, and the ultimate beneficiaries are Nigerians and the country. You cannot measure it in naira and kobo, that's what I tell people. But in service and the lifespan of human beings, you can measure it. You see, you don't know how many lives have been saved by the Kaduna Abuja being in operation. You don't know how many accidents on the road that have been avoided because of the train service. You don't know how many potholes have developed on the road without rail service because the train labs will use it, and it may be more than the design capacity of the road, and the road will fail, and eventually people ride on the road, their cars will enter potholes, and their vehicles will go bad. So how do you quantify that? But we get to a stage where even the rail development will start earning money for balance operation and break even. Because when you are investing, you have to make enough investment to break even. I don't think we are there yet to start breaking even. The goods are there to be carried. We need wagons, even on the narrow gauge. We need the track to be fitted so that they can run successfully. So that's why the advice and what government is doing is continue to maintain the narrow gauge while we develop the standard gauge. Because the more vehicle you move on the rail, the safer the road, the long lasting the road will be. That does not prevent those who are investing on trailers from doing business, whether their business will be enhanced, because the rail cannot go to the doorstep, it cannot go to the industry, and it cannot go to the warehouses. So those trailers will be available to from the rail head to the various places where those products are used. So it's not good for you to move on roads from Lagos to Kano or Lagos to Sokoto. It will be stressful on the person driving. I can get tired and certainly lead to accident. But nothing stop from loading from Kano to Maduguri, loading from Kano to Sokoto, loading from Zaria to Fontoua, and the trailer will stay longer. The driver will be more refreshed. He will not be depressed. So, and the business, we benefit everybody. In Nigerian Railway Corporation, the policy that because you carry valuable goods and human beings, you don't just deploy people to work without being trained. If you come as a graduate, good, you are a graduate, those who come will go under training for 2 years, both in classroom and practical experience. And they touch every aspect of train operation to have idea, and it's safety first. So we still have that system in place that once you are employed as a graduate, you still have to spend 2 years pupillage as an engineer, as a train operator, and especially the locomotive drivers. Don't just employ them today and start driving. They spend another 4 years to learn the functionality of the locomotive or what they are operating, and at least 6 months to learn the route. They have to be on the route without necessarily operating the locomotive attached to that route after 6 months, and they are do exam and they are taking on practical training or practical examination, and they are scored. That's only when you have given a certificate of competency to drive the train. So the training in railways, you can't do without it. Even you have what we call in-house training, MIC, Mutual Improvement Training, and it's done every week. Every week. So every week, a technician or a train operator must, there's a classroom that you have to go for mutual improvement training every week, once a week. Both those working railway and those not working railway, the ministry, the presidency, because I can't do it alone. And I would say our achievement has been that at least for be able to still run the narrow gauge at this critical moment, and we are building more of the standard gauge, and people are seeing it and saying that it can work. It's a good thing. And this is the first time that railway workers get their salary as when due. Before this time, I think we used to owe arrears, and people, staff used to cry before getting their salary. What they are asking for now is not that, not payment of salary. They are asking for improvement in their salary, in their welfare, and the government is also looking into that. Apart from the national minimum wage, I think they are looking to it to make sure that somebody who is carrying not only the locomotive or wagons that are worth millions of dollars, but the products also carrying human beings should be well taken care of. So that's the way we are looking for. That is the next thing we hope and pray it will come to pass. You see, I don't discuss challenges, I discuss solutions. Otherwise, I will not be managing director. The challenges are there, but are they surmountable? Yes. How do you surmount them? You have to have resources. And how do you do that? Is to manage the meager resources you have so that you can get the best output you have. We cannot do all at the same time. Like the track are supposed to be maintained every year. Do we have the resources for that? Do we have enough budget for that? No. But the little budget we have to make sure we address the place that is highly needed and the fund that you judiciously use. So those are the things we do. And the We can't beat. I tell people, if there are no challenges, there are no need to leave. Because if there is no friction, you cannot move. You will be slippery. So challenges is a sort of a motivating factor for me. And I take it one after the other. A challenge, what you think is challenge today may not be a challenge tomorrow. So it's just if we have enough resources and funds or on our side, the willpower I think is there. The minister is very serious about ensuring that that train is okay. The government is also providing necessary enabling environment and support. So I think we should ensure that all those of us that have to deliver what the government is expecting, we should work extra hard, work, devote our time and be committed to what we do. I graduated as an electrical engineer from the University of Lagos some years back, that's 1985, and I joined the Nigerian Railway Corporation in 1987, and I've been there as my local elsewhere. And I've gone around the country while working in railway. I'm a family man with children, and they are all grown up. And I'm somebody who prefer to, the more people you help, the more people that are happy around you, the happier I become, because there is nothing like enabling people, like nothing like making people feel that they are living well, and that nothing like putting joy in people's life. So that is the way I was brought up, and that is the way I will continue to live. And I'm sure that, as I tell people, if he has paid me that far, why do you change? I say, first of all, I have a wife that has understood, because understood the type of job I took. Before I got married, I was in railway, and then we had moving from place to place. And luckily, was able to key in, and my children and my wife, they understood that I've been up and doing. And as a real man, you don't have a fixed address. So they took it, but they have a fixed address, and I make sure they are provided for them. And any little time I have, I'll be with them full time. So I try to balance it, and they are not complaining, and they support me. They give me all the support to do my role.
Please do follow us on our social media platform for more updates and comments. On Facebook, Bodijo Media Communications Limited. On Twitter, BOJ_TV. On WhatsApp, 0703-477-8568. Our email, bodijomedia@yahoo.com. For more updates from BOJ TV, kindly click on the subscribe button and the notification bell sign beside.